CIET-NCERT presents to you the series Nectar of Poetry. Friends, in this series, we bring to you the poems by some well-known poets of English. In this program, we bring to you the poem
Love Came to Flora, Toru Dutt. Dear friends, today we will be introduced to the poet Toru Dutt. Born 1856, died in the year 1877. You will notice that she died at a very young age. She was an Indian poet. Her mother tongue was Bangla. She studied at Cambridge and began to write poems in English and French. She also translated 166 French poems into English. Toru Dutt's poems speak of birds and flowers, Indian myths, love and friendship. Let us go through her poem, Love Came to Flora. Love came to Flora, asking for a flower, that would of flowers be undisputed queen. The lily and the rose long, long had been rivals for that high honor. Bards of power had sung their claims. The rose can never tower like the pale lily with her jurio mien. But is the lily lovelier? Thus between flower factions rang the strife in Psyche's bore. Give me a flower, delicious as the rose, and stately as the lily in her pride. But of what colour? Rose red, love first chose, then prayed, no, lily white, or both provide? And Flora gave the lotus. Rose red died, and lily white, the queenliest flower that blows, the queenliest flower that blows. The speaker describes how love comes to Flora, the goddess of flowers, and asks her to name one flower as the queen. The rose and the lily were both competitors for the title. Some said that the lily is so graceful and royal. Some said the rose is lovelier. All the flowers are divided in their opinion. The goddess creates a flower that blooms in two colors, lily white and rose red. Toru Dutt presents the idea that the lotus is the most beautiful flower. It also blooms in lily white. In Indian tradition, the lotus stem grows above water. The flower is beautiful in spite of the impurity of the water. A second meaning can be that although Toru Dutt travelled afar and was educated abroad, she retained her Indian roots. Can you count the lines in the poem? Yes, you're right. It contains 16 lines. A poem of 16 lines is called a sonnet. Now find out the meaning of ballad and limerick.
Friends, you were just listening to this program. Subject coordination, Dr. Ravindra Kumar. Subject expert, Dr. Vardha M. Nikalje. Support, Department of Education in Languages. Artist, Suchitra Gupta. Recorded by Bati Langlingdo. Production assistants, Vimlesh Chaudhary. Directed and produced by Ajit Horo. This program is presented to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.